Greetings, brethren. We are very grateful and thankful as we progress in this topic, what happens when we die. Today we wanted to talk about the Halloween, but because I've realized that there's so much to cover, we're going to step back a little bit in part three, but in part four, we're going to talk about Halloween. We have already spoken about what happens when people die, and we have noticed that actually a soul can die. The Bible says in Ezekiel chapter 18 verse 4, which is just a recap we're doing, "Behold, all souls are mine as the soul of the Father, so also the soul of the Son. The soul that sinneth, it shall die." So we've also realized that a soul cannot exist outside the body, and we've realized that a soul is a combination of the breath of life, which is a gift from God, and the dust of the earth, which is our body. And now there is nothing called a soul that can exist outside the body. We have also realized that, you know, at death humanity becomes unconscious. We go to sleep, in which we do not dream, in which we cannot talk, and then death actually makes the close of earth's history. And will not live again on earth after death. Remember, the book of Hebrews chapter 9 says, "It is appointed unto men once to die, and then judgment." So therefore, after we have died on earth, we cannot live again. And also we've realized that the dead cannot worship. The Bible says in the book of Psalms chapter 115:17, "The dead praise not the Lord, neither any that goeth down into silence." So if you die, oh, the dead, they cannot praise the Lord. They have gone to silence. And when they are in a silence, they can neither talk nor communicate. Neither can we communicate, neither can we talk to them. Therefore, there is no worship when someone is dead. The Bible says, in fact, let's look at what David says in the book of Psalms chapter 6 verse 5. It says, "For in death there is no remembrance of thee, in grave who shall give thee thanks?" In other words, he is saying, in death, can somebody give you thanks when they are dead? The answer is no one, because there is no consciousness in death. Only the conscious person can reason and praise. Therefore, if somebody is in the grave, they cannot communicate. If somebody is dead, they have no portion in anything that is done under the sun. And also we realize that the dead cannot return back to their house. Job chapter 7 verse 10, "He shall return no more to his house, neither shall his place know him anymore." That's why you find that, you know, those that lived after somebody has died, they will share those things. The inheritance that has been left by the dead person is shared among his loved ones. Why? Because he has no portion anymore on anything that is done under the sun. And also we realize that, you know, when someone is dead, he's actually useless. They are not good anymore. That's why we put them in the graves, or sometimes we cremate them. They are no good to us anymore because they are dead. The Bible says in the books chapter 115, Psalms chapter 146, verse 3, "Put not your trust in princes, nor in the Son of Man, in whom there is no help." Why is there no help in the Son of Man? "His breath goeth forth, he returneth to the earth, and in that very day his thoughts perished." Now, Solomon put this differently in the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 9 verse 4. He compares a lion, a dead lion, and a living dog. He says in verse 4, "For to him that is joined to all the living there is hope. For a living dog is better than a dead lion. Though a living lion could be powerful, if it is dead, it is useless. A dog becomes more powerful because a dog can bark, a dog is living, a dog can bite, but a dead lion is of no use." So that actually means that, you know, you may be powerful when you are alive. You may be doing some great things when you are alive. But when you are dead, then you are useless. Therefore, make use of your time while you are still alive, because you are powerful. Now, Isaiah says there is no hope in death. He says in Isaiah chapter 38, verse 18, "For the grave cannot praise thee, death cannot celebrate thee. They that go down into the pit cannot hope for thy truth." If there is no hope for the truth in the grave, then the doctrine of purgatory. It's a fake doctrine. Because there is no hope. If there is no hope, there is no salvation. If there is no celebration in death, then there is no pain. That means there is no heaven or hell in death. So people, they don't go to heaven or to hell when they are dead. But now the question is, what happened to the spirit? Now, because, you know, we seem to have associated the spirit and soul, and there is a belief that my spirit goes to heaven. Now, now the question is, when the spirit goes to heaven, is the spirit conscious? Now, the Bible makes it very clear where the spirit goes. In Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 19, the Bible says, "For that which befalleth the sons of men befalleth beasts, even one thing befalleth them. As the one dies, so dies the other. Yea, they have all one breath, so that a man has no preeminence above a beast, for all is vanity." No, the spirit that is in the beast and the spirit that is in the human being is one and the same. Therefore, at death, their spirit goes to the same place. There is the human being spirit will not take a preeminence above the beast, because they are all created the same. Now, what exactly does that mean? It actually means that, you know, when we die, if we believe that our soul goes to heaven, therefore, the soul of the animal will also go to heaven. But now Solomon makes it very clear on verse 20. He says, "All go unto one place." Now the question is, where is this place they go? And say, "All are of the dust, and all go again to the dust. Who knoweth the spirit of man that goeth upward, and the spirit of the beast that goeth downward to earth?" So this question is very interesting, that, you know, the spirit of the animal and the spirit of a human being, they all go to the same place. The destination of both is one, back to the ground where they came from. By the way how humanity was created is the same way how animals were created. They are all from the dust. The spirit of both is destined to one place. The spirit returns to God that gives it, as it was from the beginning, where there was nothing. So therefore, as we have already realized, the soul will be dead. So when someone dies, the soul is dead. If we believe that the soul of a human being lives on, then we should also believe that the soul of an animal lives on. If we believe that human beings can survive bodily death, then we should also believe that animals survive bodily death. But however, God in his love and mercy, he has promised that there will be a resurrection only for human beings. Why? Because Jesus died. Jesus did not die for animals. He died for human beings, and God promised that humanity will resurrect. The Bible says in the book of John chapter 5, 28, "Marvel not at this, for the hour is coming in that which all that are in the grave shall hear his voice." Those who are in the grave, talking to people, relating to people who are in the grave, they will hear his voice, and they shall come forth. They that have done good unto the resurrection of life, and they that have done evil unto the resurrection of damnation. Resurrection will definitely happen for both the just and the unjust. At that time, we will either be resurrected to go to heaven or hell. The choice we make today determines our destination. Therefore, it's actually very important that while we are still alive, to make use of the time that we have. However, there is a great confusion in many Christians today, and many people, you hear them preaching that, you know, when you die, you go to heaven. They quote the words of Jesus when he was on the cross talking to the robber, and they said, you know, Jesus said, I will be with you in paradise. So Jesus and the robber, they went to heaven on the same day. But now listen, let's look at the verse. It's actually Luke chapter 23, verse 42. The Bible says, Luke chapter 23, verse 42. "And he said unto Jesus, Lord, remember me when thou comest into thy kingdom. And Jesus said unto him, Verily I say unto thee, today shalt thou be with me in paradise. This verse seemed to suggest that the thief and Jesus went to heaven on that very day. But now the question, let's actually look at this very closely. Let's ask some few questions regarding this verse. Now the question is, did Jesus and the thief went to paradise that very day? Did they go to heaven on that very day? If they went to heaven on that very day, then the Bible is flawed. Now, number two, do people go to heaven without their bodies? Because we know that Jesus was buried on that very day. And if that is true, then there is no need to believe what Christ says. There is no need to believe in the Bible because it's all lies. But now remember, the Bible does not contradict itself. Now the question is, what exactly does it mean? Now the Bible is very clear. Let's actually find out, because Jesus said, I will be with you in paradise. Let's find out where the paradise is. When you read from the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 12 verse 4, Paul says, how that he was caught up into paradise. Paul is talking about a vision that he had. He was caught into paradise. So in heaven he went. In the vision, Paul went all the way to paradise. But now the question is, where exactly is paradise? The Bible says in the book of Revelation chapter 2 verse 7, he that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit say to the churches. To him that overcometh, will I give to eat of the tree which is in the midst of paradise. Okay, there is a tree that is in the midst of paradise. So if the tree is in the midst of paradise, now the question is, where is paradise and where is this tree? Revelation chapter 22 verse 14, the Bible says, blessed are they that do his commandments, that they may have right to the tree of life and may enter through the gates into the city. Right? So now they enter through the gates into the city. Which city are we talking about in Revelation chapter 22? We are talking about New Jerusalem, the city of God. So the tree which is in paradise, it's in the city of God. Therefore, it's actually very clear that paradise is in heaven. The tree is in heaven. Therefore, if the Bible, if we're talking about paradise, if Jesus went to paradise, it means that he went to heaven with the thief. But now the question is, did Jesus Christ go to heaven on Friday when he was dead? The Bible says in John chapter 20 verse 17, finding out where Jesus was, Jesus saith unto her, touch me not, for I am not yet ascend to my Father, but go to my brethren and say unto them, I ascend unto my Father and your Father, and to my God and your God. Jesus was buried on Friday. He did not go to paradise. He was in the grave, and on Sunday he's saying to Maria, to Mary, do not touch me. I've not been to the Father. In other words, I've not been to heaven yet. Therefore, it's actually very clear that Jesus and the robber did not go to heaven. Now, the question is, what happened? We know that Jesus was buried on Friday. What happened to the robber? The robber did not die on Friday. The Bible makes it very clear in John chapter 19, verse 31, that, you know, it says, the Jews therefore, because it was preparation that the body should not remain upon the cross on the Sabbath, for that Sabbath day was an high day, besought Pilate that their legs might be broken and that they might be taken away. Then come the soldiers and break the legs of the first and of the other which was crucified with him. Therefore, the reason why they broke their legs, so that they will not run away. The cross was a painful, slow death. The thief did not die on Friday. Therefore, it is a flawed doctrine to believe that the thief and Jesus went to heaven. They did not go to paradise. Jesus went into his grave. He was there until the resurrection morning, and the thief was still alive. And after Sabbath, the thief was hanged back to the cross. But you find that, you know, when the Bible was compiled, it was compiled without punctuation and commas. And the problem with this verse is only the position of the comma. Now the question is, how should we understand the verse? The verse should be read, assuredly I say unto you today, we put a comma, you will be with me in paradise. The emphasis was not on the word today. In other words, in fact, the emphasis on this was on the word today. In other words, he told the thief, I am promising you today, even though I do not look victorious, even though I do not look as king of the kings, but I promise you today, I will be with you in paradise. At the fullness of time, the thief will be resurrected to be ushered into the paradise. You know, I know this is a great confusion to many, because you were promised that the moment you die, you go to heaven. No, the Bible does not teach that. Now, I know that many of you now have a question. What about the rich man and Lazarus? What about Saul? What about that witch of Endor? Remember, that's our next episode. We'll be talking about the witch of Endor. What happened to Saul? What happened to Samuel and the witch of Endor? What about Jesus preaching to the spirits which were in prison? I can assure you, nothing is further from the truth. In our next episode, we are dealing with the spirits that come out of the ground. We are looking at the witch of Endor. We are looking at the spirits which operates among us. What's happening in the CN's chamber? Until then, keep tuned to the Herald Report as we continue to unpack this wonderful truth, so that we know that if we rest in the Lord, we have guaranteed that when He shall come, we'll be resurrected to go to heaven, where a home has been prepared for us all.